गुड मॉर्निंग सर, आवर क्लास फोर सोशल स्टडीज लेसन नंबर फोर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टुडे, दैट इज क्लाइमेट इन इंडिया। बिफोर दैट नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टू नो व्हाई ओनली लाइफ इज पॉसिबल ओनली ऑन आवर प्लैनेट अर्थ, बिकॉज देयर आर नंबर ऑफ रीजंस। वन फर्स्ट रीजन इज दैट आवर प्लैनेट अर्थ इज द ओनली प्लैनेट विच हैज वाटर ऑन इट, एंड सेकेंड रीजन इज बिकॉज ऑफ द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ वाटर ऑन इट, then because of the atmosphere, the presence of atmosphere which is making life possible on the earth. Atmosphere, what is the meaning of atmosphere? You have already learned about atmosphere in the class 3. Atmosphere means the mixture of air. Atmosphere is nothing but the mixture of air. Let us try to know, see, this is our planet Earth, and our planet Earth is surrounded by the layer of air. This is atmosphere. Because of the presence of atmosphere, life is possible on the Earth. So atmosphere means, the atmosphere is nothing but the mixture of gases. Gases like oxygen, which we breathe in, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, etc. There are number of gases which are present in the atmosphere. Not only gases, even dust particles are also present in the atmosphere. Even the tiny drops of water are also present in the atmosphere. That is making life possible on the earth. So what the term atmosphere means? The mixture of gases. Now let us come to the term temperature. Temperature means whether it is hot or cool or cold. You know, whenever we get fever, we go to a doctor, and doctor will use a thermometer to check our body temperature. Means if we have more heat in our body, it means we have a fever. If our body is warm, it means we don't have a fever. Same like that, temperature means whether it's hot or a cold. Even temperature, we use particular instrument to find out the temperature of a particular place also. Let us come to the word humidity. Humidity means the amount of water vapor, tiny drops of water or water vapor present in air is called humidity. If the water vapor is more, means we feel more hot. Alright, if the amount of water vapor is less, means we feel cool. Now coming to the word term weather. Now all these things will affect the weather. What is weather? Weather is the condition of a place, the atmospheric conditions of a place over a short period of time. This weather, you know children, will keep on changing every time. Short period of time. Now, this term we use for the day-to-day change or the daily changes in the atmospheric conditions of workplaces. Now, today's weather, yesterday, count it, today's weather is quite cool, right? Whereas, yesterday, whole day it was raining. You know, there was a slight shower or there was sometimes it was raining heavily. So, because of the weather condition, that is described as weather conditions. Yesterday, we had different conditions and today we have different conditions. Even, you know, at present, it is not raining outside. It is cool weather. It is not at all raining outside. It is cool. Cool winds are blowing. But after 1 hour, weather may change. It may rain or it may not rain. Or even sunshine may come out. Alright, weather means the atmospheric conditions of a particular place over a short period of time. It may change in an hour or in a 1 hour or half an hour. So, the conditions of sunshine, rain, wind as well as the temperature of a particular place. Now, how do we measure the weather? How do we know whether it is going to rain? After how the weather is going to be after 1 hour or after some time? So, different instruments are used. Different instruments are used to know the weather condition of a particular place. See children, these are the different instruments. Here it is an image picture of different instruments which are used to know the weather conditions of a particular place. There are different instruments which are used. Thermometer is used to know whether it is going to be hot or cool. For example, there are so many instruments which are used to know the weather conditions of a particular place. So, the information how the weather is going to be in the next day or in the near future is called weather forecast. Now, this weather forecast is very useful to know the weather conditions of a particular place. So, now let us try to see the weather forecast. It is not necessary, you know, I want to know the weather of the today's and plus tomorrow's. Means, I don't have to bring all these instruments and find out the weather conditions. We can also use the internet in our phone and we can just type here weather. I will type here weather in Hyderabad. See, after typing here weather in Hyderabad, a picture has come out. It is showing 24 degrees Celsius or 24 degree Fahrenheit. Not only that, it is also showing the weather condition of today, tomorrow Saturday, then again Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Like this, it will show the weather conditions of the particular place. We can use our internet also to know the weather conditions of a place. No need to use all the instruments. Alright, what is the use of knowing about the weather conditions? Weather forecast. This weather forecast will help us in many, not only help, it will help many people whose work is affected because of the weather conditions. For example, you take farmers, you know, they are working fields, polar. So, these farmers, when they work in fields, when the time is there for them to sow the seeds or harvest, so it will help them to, their work is affected because of the weather conditions. So, not only that, now your father will go to office or your mama goes out to work or to get something or to go to shopping. If you know previously, before only, that how the weather is going to be tomorrow or after 1 hour, you can take precautions. For example, if you know after 1 hour it is going to rain, what you will do? You will carry an umbrella. Your father will carry a raincoat or rain suit. So, they will be safe from the rain. Alright. So, this is the use of weather forecast. Alright children. Weather, what is the meaning of weather? Weather means the atmospheric conditions of a particular place over a short period of time. Whether it is 1 hour, 1.5 hour or 2 hours. So, this weather is affected, includes everything. Atmosphere, temperature, humidity, all these are included in the weather conditions. Now let us come to the climatic conditions. What is meant by climate? Climate means the weather conditions. See children, the weather, what is coming here? Weather conditions of a place over a long period of time. Weather conditions will affect only, weather is condition will affect only short period of time, whereas climatic conditions will affect for long period of time, for around 2 or 3 months. So in this way, the climatic conditions, because of these climatic conditions, we experience seasons. Climate means the weather conditions of a place over a long period of time. Because of the climatic conditions, we experience different seasons. Now, what do you mean by seasons? The period of the year when a particular type of weather, a period in a year, whether when a particular type of weather is expected, same type of weather is expected for almost 2 to 3 months. Okay, children. Now let us try to know about the climatic conditions of the places in India. The climatic conditions in India. You know, because of the different climatic conditions we have in our country, there are so many reasons. We have already learned in our previous class that our India has 6 different physical features or divisions. Because of those 6 physical divisions also, the climate in India is affected or is different. Whereas, see, you know, Jaisalmer, which is in Rajasthan, it is, that particular place is dry and hot throughout the year. Whereas, Ladakh is the place where we find the very cold type of climate. See the difference here. Jaisalmer in Rajasthan, because this place is situated in the desert area, that's why this place, Jaisalmer, have a dry type of climate. Dry and hot type of climate throughout the year. Whereas Ladakh is in Jammu Kashmir. So Ladakh is in Jammu Kashmir. Ladakh has very cold type of climate throughout the year. See the difference. Because this Ladakh is situated in the mountain side, another mountain region, that's why Ladakh has a different climate. Now take one more example, that is Meghalaya. Now Meghalaya is also situated in mountain regions only, but this particular place receives heavy rainfall compared to all other places in India. So in the year, which particular place receives heavy rainfall means that state Meghalaya receives heavy rainfall in India. Now let us know different climatic reasons. What are the factors which are affecting the climate of India? First of all, let us know that what type of climate we have in India. We have a tropical monsoon type of climate. Because of varied reasons, India has tropical monsoon type of climate. Tropical monsoon type of climate. Now, the different factors. The factors which are affecting the climate of India. There are number of factors. First one is physical. In this only all will come. Physical features. Because different places are situated in different regions. Some states are situated in mountain regions. Some are situated in plateau regions, some are situated in coastal regions. That's why these places have different type of climate in the India. So, some of the reasons, one more reason is distance from the sea. This is one of the main reasons why we have a different climate in India, that is distance from the sea. Means a particular place, if it is near to sea, because the cool winds which are blowing from the sea, they make the place cool, and the places which are away from the sea, they experience hot type of climate. The best example for this is, for example, Goa. Goa is a state, it is located here. You know, this is the map of India, and Goa is here. Beside Karnataka and Maharashtra, Goa is situated on the coastal region side, coast side. So this Goa has, you know, cool type of climate throughout the year. The climate here won't change. It has cool type of climate because of the Bay of Arabian Sea here, because of the Arabian Sea. The climate of Goa is cool. Whereas Delhi is which is away from the sea. Now see, Arabian Sea is here and Delhi is here. See how far it is. How far it is from the sea. Because of this, Delhi experiences a different type of climate. Means very hot in summers and very cold in winters. This is the reason. One main reason is because Delhi is away from the water body, that's why it will experience very hot in summers and very cold in winters. The second reason is altitude. Altitude of a place. Teachers, in our previous class we have learned that India has a plateau region. Plateau means a elevated land or a table raised land but flat at the top. So because of the place which is situated at higher level, because of that also the climatic conditions will differ here. Example I gave you, Ladakh. Ladakh is a state in Jammu, place in Jammu Kashmir where it is very cold throughout the year. Why? Because Ladakh is situated at a higher place in the mountain region. Ladakh is situated in mountain region. That's why the climate in this region is very different compared to other parts of India. Now another one more reason is directions of the wind. Directions of the wind also is one of the reasons why we have a different climate in India. When the winds are blowing from the seas, they make the places cool. The places which are near to the sea, we for example these places which are here, located here in the coastal regions, these places are cool because the winds are making these places cool. The winds which are blowing here, they make the place cool. Whereas other the places which are far from the seas, they have a hot type of climate. The winds coming from cold regions make the place cool. So winds which are blowing from the mountain regions, they will make the places cool. Alright children. So and the winds which are blowing from in the desert region, the winds which are blowing in the desert regions, they will make the particular place hot. So that is the best example for this. Winds coming from cold regions make the place cool with, and the winds which are coming from the hotter regions, for example desert regions, they will make the places hot as well as humid. So because of these factors, India has a tropical monsoon type of climate. Generally in India we have four main seasons. Let us come to the seasons in India. In India we have four main seasons. Those are, children, we have covered the topic weather and climate as well as difference between weather and climate. And now let us know about the seasons. Seasons in India. Generally there are four seasons. India experiences four seasons. Those are summer. This summer season lasts from the month of March till June. Till the starting of the June, this summer season last year almost from March, April, May and starting place of the June. Then comes monsoon. Monsoon season starts from the mid-June continues up to September. Mid-September also we can say. And last till the month of September. Then comes the third season where the monsoon returns. Means retreating. R-E-T-R-E-A-T-I-N-G. Retreating monsoon. This one will continue from the month of October to November. October to November. So, retreating monsoon means the winds will return. The winds which are blowing from the southwest side. So, this is south direction, children. This is west direction. So, the winds which are blowing from southwest direction, they will return to northeast. This is east direction and here is north direction. So these winds will return to northeast direction. So as they are returning, that is called as retreating monsoon. And the fourth season is winter. This lasts from the month of December till mid-February. So, these are the four seasons of India. That is summer, monsoon, retreating monsoon and the winter season. In summer, this summer season lasts for the 4 months. That is March, April, May, June. Not 3.5 months. Till June starting. Then comes the monsoon season. Monsoon season starts from the mid-June and lasts till the September. And retreating monsoon means returning monsoon. The southwest monsoons will return to northeast. So that time is October to November. And the winter season. This winter season lasts from December till February month. So these are the seasons in India. Because we have different seasons, all these seasons together form the climate of a region. However, because of the variety of physical features in India, there are many variations which within one season in our country. For example, during the monsoon season, while the coast of Maharashtra and Kerala receives heavy rainfall, the state of Rajasthan remains almost dry. So these coastal areas, during the monsoon season, these coastal areas receive heavy rainfall. Whereas the Rajasthan, there is a main region in Rajasthan, because it is a desert region, it will remain dry as well as hot even in the monsoon region. It will receive very little rainfall or almost no rainfall. So this was about the climate of India. We have learned in this lesson about the weather. What is weather? Weather means the day-to-day changes in the atmosphere. Then we have already learned, about climate. Climate means the weather conditions of a particular place over a long period of time. So then we have learned about the factors which are affecting the climate of a particular place. The different factors are distance from the sea, directions of the wind and altitude of a particular place. These are the factors which are affecting the climate of a place. Then we have learned about seasons in India or seasons of India. We have four main seasons. Those are summer season, monsoon season, retreating monsoon season and winter season. This was about the lesson, children. Please go to the lesson, read it. You will understand it a little bit more. If you have a doubt, post in the